Hello and welcome to the final full week of the school year. You are watching D93 News.
Yes, Phil, it was a busy week in the district and our top story comes from Discovery. Now, Phil, as you know, the blog story by Nigel Tom has more than 3 million words. Wood Men of Goodwill has more than 2 million words. Cyrus the Great does as well. Now, combine these behemoths of literature and you would still be about 2 million words short of what Tayson Jones read it this year at Discovery.
There's no way. I swear you made those books. I've never heard of those books, but nonetheless, it's incredible. Tayson read more than 10 million words, and he is leaving Mrs. Piper's class with a record that may never be broken.
I enjoy reading a lot, so I just read over the summer and read in the school year, and I took lots of AR quizzes for points. And eventually got to 10 million words, and that was my goal.
Now, staying at Discovery, Mrs. Boren did a book study about endangered animals with her third grade class. And after reading the story, her class decided they wanted to do something to help. For the last 2 weeks, on Mondays and Wednesdays, they have put up a lemon endangered stand. They are raising money to send to the World Wildlife Fund. Their last lemonade stand will be on the 25th, and they are getting closer to reaching their goal of raising $500.
So endangered animals like gorillas and elephants and stuff and other animals don't die.
Helping endangered animals that need help so they can survive.
It takes a lot of work to put on a district-wide musical review. It even takes more work to start one. That's exactly what Tennille Serre is trying to do, and she could use your help. Auditions are being held on June 3rd for junior high and high school students in the district.
We are getting ready to launch a new tradition, hopefully. We're going to be doing a musical review with the district and try to include a lot of the Bonneville kids and Hillcrest and even include Rocky Mountain and Sand Creek kids. And we're hoping to do a musical in September.
Now, for more information, please call 201-3380.
Rite of passage. Sam, that's a term we've heard a lot in the last couple of weeks, mm-hmm. And it continues this week. There are grade specific activities for just about everyone. The sixth graders started it off with their annual track meet at Thunder Stadium last week.
Kids an opportunity to show what they have going and to come out and compete, get ready for middle school and high school.
And Phil, the fourth grade rendezvous was held later in the week at Iona Park. And this is a great opportunity for the students to learn more about Idaho's history.
They do. The kids look forward to this. The teachers are working with their students all year long, doing Idaho history, talking about the Oregon Trail and the westward migration of our country and all those things. And so they get to talk a lot about the mountain man era. And so the students really look forward to coming to this event and seeing some actual, you know, artifacts and some tangible evidence of what life was like back in the 1820s, 30s, 40s, those kinds of things.
Iona Park, as you know, that will be the place to be for many students in D93, as it's typically been the resting spot during the fifth grade bike ride. But Principal Murdoch of Ammon Elementary says there are some big changes happening this year.
We're switching it up, and the South schools are going to Peterson Park instead of Third Iona. So we're developing our own routes through the neighborhoods, and the police are still going to support us with that. The big road crossing we have is Ammon. And so we got some help to block that off while Hillview and Ammon ride across. And then because it's closer, we get to spend more time doing activities at the park. So the kids are looking forward to it. We'll still have a good bike ride, but I think it's going to be a little bit more effective to maximize the time and not worry so much about breakdowns.
Now, most students go home and go straight to homework, right? I don't know about that. My kids don't. Some might hang out with their friends. About a dozen fifth and sixth grade students in Ammon Elementary recently got together to form a basketball team. The team competed in the YMCA League, where many of the teams they played had a lot more experience. That didn't stop them from finishing the season with a winning record.
Everything. It was amazing.
Sam, I had a chance to help with that team. So proud of those kids that came a long way. Now, the district celebrated this year's batch of retirees with an annual retirement open house at the district office. 27 retirees were honored during the special ceremony. Now, Sam, so many names. We were going through it during our broadcast that day. Just huge shoes to fill.
Appreciate all the service that they have done for District 93.
They will be missed. Well, that's going to do it for us. We'll see you next time on D93 News.